Gold prices opened higher after a big sell-off on Friday, but weren't able to sustain that trade as we got north of 1600 early in the session, and then we spent most of the rest of the session chipping away to the downside. Volumes were mediocre, but at this point, it seems like looking for bids to hit as it was a preservation of capital type trade. Likewise, we saw equities rebound. We have rumors of Fed intervention, maybe from G7 talks that are coming this week, and it just seems that everything has become very disconnected. With this type of environment, a high-risk environment with high uncertainty and outcomes very, very difficult to pinpoint, you would think gold prices would be rallying here. And they did rally, but after Friday's sell-off, we've kind of lost a little bit of our momentum. And the market right now looks to gravitate towards that 1600 level. We'll probably stay close to it unless there's some kind of a headline news that scares the market higher, or there is some kind of clarity which either sells us back down to, down closer to 1550, or obviously the clarity isn't what we're hoping for, and we see fear come back into the market and rally us higher. It's a very much a choppy trade. It will continue to be. The moves higher and lower are very violent, and I don't see any way that changes until we get more time, we get our sea legs back under us, and we start to see really what happens. What's the Fed really going to do? What are the other central banks really going to do? And when we get that kind of clarity, then we may get some price stability. But at this point, 1600 seems like a fair area, fair value for where we see all the levers and pulleys right now. And I look at the dollar. The dollar was hit very hard today. Obviously, that helped gold prices early, but it becomes a very disconnected market because the dollar rallied late, even as equities were rallying and treasuries were selling off. And it was just it's a very much across the board, a very confusing looking trade from 50,000 feet. And at this point, positioning becomes an issue in gold as well. There's still a lot of longs out there in gold. And yeah, some of them got out over the past few weeks. But at this point, it's very difficult to say what you're selling your gold against, or whether it's an insurance policy you're buying, and maybe you just don't think you need the insurance policy anymore. But gold prices right now hovering around 1600, the dollar very mixed, and certainly Fed intervention is gonna have an effect on both of those things if it comes to fruition, which expectations are that could happen very soon. Speculators they were unloading some of those longs over the last few weeks. We won't know the totals for last week until this Friday, but at this point, it's safe to say that on that big sell-off Friday, we saw speculators getting out. Maybe they were looking to reload as the market crept earlier this morning when we opened up and saw the big rally, but ultimately it failed. So speculators may be looking for better areas to get in, or they may be looking in other areas to push, to look, maybe looking at other asset classes. Given the sell-off in stocks, they may have been more attractive. Given the way the bond market is traded, we saw a big rip higher in yields late in the afternoon as stocks rallied. So there's just a very much a disconnect here. Gold prices in this type of environment are usually higher and moving higher very quickly, but we're not seeing that here. So it's be very interesting to see what happens when the Fed comes out. They are expected to cut 50 basis points sometime between now and or at March FOMC. And some are even talking about another 25 basis point cut in April. So you got 75 basis points of cuts coming up. The market priced that in very quickly, and that would usually be very gold bullish, but it wasn't. So again, the disconnect between the market continues. Gold prices near 1600 until further notice. Obviously, if we get any kind of clarity and we start looking ahead beyond the March and April FOMCs, then that would certainly give us some clarity in gold, likely lower prices if we think they're done after rate cuts at March and April. But at this point, gold buyers will be patient and waiting, because we all know what happens when the Fed takes rates down close to zero. They keep them down close to zero. At least they did the last time they did this about a decade ago. And I think that gold buyers will look to take advantage of that after the Fed cuts. It could be a choppy trade between now and then, but look for gold buyers to step up as rates go down, and they look to go down very quickly if the Fed acts within the next few weeks.